It's good to welcome you again to St. Patrick's Cathedral for the next in the current series of recitals on the Willis organ by Mr. David Leigh, the organist and assistant master of the music. It is our hope that in these stressful times, you will not only enjoy the music, but that should you be ill or self-isolating, it will bring you peace and enhance you in spirit. The programme features one major work by the composer Franz Liszt. Serendipity played a role in the origin of this piece. Franz Liszt, who was weary from almost 10 years of constant touring as a pianist, was giving a concert in Kiev in the Ukraine when he happened by chance to meet a Polish princess, Caroline von Sein-Wittgenstein, who was also at a personal crossroads in her life. She and Liszt fell in love, apparently. He abandoned the public concert stage and they went to live in Weimar, where Liszt had already wanted to spend time composing, particularly as he had been offered an influential post there some years previously by the Grand Duke, but could never take up the offer because of his relentless tour commitments. Weimar offered Liszt an orchestra, an opera house, and a kindred spirit in the Grand Duke. The dream went unfulfilled, although the relationship with the princess lasted 40 years. Liszt, however, is regarded as having composed some of his finest music during the 13 years he and Caroline spent at Weimar, where J.S. Bach had lived and composed for a previous Grand Duke some 100 years earlier. Liszt's Fantasia and Fugue on the chorale Ad nos ad salutarem undam, the first of Liszt's organ compositions, and remember, Liszt's instrument was piano rather than organ, was directly inspired not by Bach, but by Giacomo Meyerbeer, a German composer of opera, and the huge success of his opera Le Prophète in 1849. Following year, Liszt wrote a Fantasia and Fugue on the chorale Ad nos ad salutarem undam, the rabble-rousing call to repentance and re-baptism that the three Anabaptists sing in Act I of Le Prophète. This is a monumental work in three main parts. The opening Fantasia states the theme plainly in C minor and then takes it through a creative rush of transformations and contrasting textures. It comes to a close in a recitative section and then takes lyrical flight in a warm adagio in F sharp major, the key Liszt favorite for exalted religious subjects and as remote as possible from the flat keys dominating the Fantasia. The martial and freely developed fugue returns the music to C minor before closing with the chorale blazing away in C major. Incidentally, Liszt had a number of distinguished pupils, including Julius Reubke, who died tragically at a young age, and whose sonata on the 94th Psalm, which we heard in the summer here, is modelled on this piece. Fantasia and Fugue on the chorale Ad nos ad salutarem undam by Franz Liszt.
Thank you.
David Leigh on the organ of St. Patrick's Cathedral, Dublin, of the Fantasia and Fugue on the chorale Ad Nos Ad Salutarem Undam by Franz Liszt, brings today's recital to a close. We offer Mr. Leigh our deepest thanks, as always, for his superb playing, in this case of a monumental work which requires not only a lot of skill and technique, but also huge physical effort. So very well done indeed to David, and our thanks to him for this new series of recitals. Thanks also to you for listening to this recording. I do hope that you will keep in touch and join us again for the next recital, which will feature Sir Edward Elgar's Sonata for Organ in G major. Until then, please take care and keep safe and well.